Paper number 3 is Reconstitution of Purple Membraned Vesicles Catalyzing Light-Driven Proton Uptake and Adenosine Triphosphate Formation by Ephraim Racker and Walter Stoeckenius. Published in the Journal of Biological Chemistry in 1974. This paper answers Peter Mitchell's third question. How do electron transport chains do what they do? The first experimental step was to purify membrane proteins from a purple photosynthetic bacterium called Halobacterium halobium. Halobacterium halobium was only one protein in its membrane. We now know that purple protein is called bacteriorhodopsin. We also now know that Halobacterium halobium is classified as archaea and not bacteria, but those things were not known in 1974. Purple protein responds to light by transporting protons. The next step of the procedure was to use soybean lipids to make artificial membrane vesicles. Then, Racker and Stoeckenius inserted the purple protein into the artificial membrane vesicles. When a light was turned on, protons were transported in their membrane vesicles. And when the light was turned off, proton production stopped. They measured proton concentration by measuring pH changes in the medium. The next step was to make membrane vesicles with different amounts of purple protein. When they turned on the light, the amount of protons that were transported was proportional to the amount of purple protein. Racker and Stoeckenius then took the next step and they incorporated proteins from bovine heart mitochondria into their membrane vesicles. We now know that the protein that they incorporated was ATP synthase. When they added light to their artificial membrane system, what happened was that protons formed inside the vesicles. And they were transported out via the mitochondrial protein. And ATP was generated. By combining photosynthetic components and animal components in an artificial membrane system, these scientists were able to generate ATP via the proton motive force in the absence of any metabolism. In retrospect, was this system much different from the classical reductionist approach used by scientists prior to Mitchell?